Hello, everyone. Welcome to the English devotional from Soldiers of the Cross. Let's begin in prayer. O blessed Heavenly Father, we glorify your holy name. Thank you for the Sabbath day that you have given us. Thank you for the rest that we have in you. Father, I ask that you will forgive me of my sins and offenses that I've done against you so my prayer can enter your holy throne. Thank you, Lord Jesus, because of your sacrifice on the cross. Thank you, Father, for sending your Son to die for us, for sending him as a newborn babe to change the course of our destiny. Thank you for the salvation that you offer us. I ask you, Father God, that we will find spiritual rest, physical rest, emotional rest in you today. Guide us and direct us. Be with every person who is directing a service on this Sabbath day. May your Holy Spirit speak through them. Be with every person who is going to be giving a message or sermon today. May your Holy Spirit flow through them and edify the church. May they bring peace on your behalf to those who are listening. Father God, open up the hearts and minds of your people and those who are listening today. May their faith grow. May their strength be found in you. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Today's devotional is titled, Today is Christmas. It was written by Judith Stone and translated by Maria Elena Cardona. Our biblical base comes from Luke chapter 2, verses 1 through 20. So says the word of God. And it came to pass in those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This census first took place while Quirinius was governing Syria. So all went to be registered, everyone to his own city. Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed wife, who was with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were completed for her to be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Now there were in the same country shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were greatly afraid. Then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all the people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign to you: you will find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men." So it was when the angel had gone away from them into heaven that the shepherds said to one another, "Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us." And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. Now when they had seen him, they made widely known the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all those who heard it marveled at those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. Then the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen, as it was told them. Amen. May we be blessed by the reading of the scripture. The festive atmosphere of the holidays through the end of the year fills the heart with memories that overflow with nostalgia and transport us on its wings to our childhood and to its wonderful days full of tender illusions and sweet expectation. Days when one of the biggest concerns as children was if we received the toys we had asked for, even though at the end of the day, we were happy with the ones we were given. What pleasant days, surrounded by the love of our parents and siblings. Men have set out to destroy everything beautiful and sweet in life, a humanity that entertains itself with bad taste, enjoying what is indecent and vulgar. But what can you expect? These also are signs of the last day. It is true that we do not know the exact date of our Savior's birth, but it is also true that he was born. That is what should really matter to us. As our founding father, the Apostle Daddy John, once said, and who always celebrated Christmas, if the world celebrates it at this time, then let's take that opportunity to tell them that Jesus loves them and wants to save them, because that is the true spirit of Christmas. Christmas, what joy! Jesus was born. Amen. My brothers and sisters, it doesn't matter if Jesus was born on December 25th or August 25th or January 1st or whatever day Jesus was born in. The point is that God sent his only begotten Son, born of a woman who knew no man intimately, into this world as a miracle. He sent his Son, Jesus, to live a perfect, sinless life, only so that he may become the wages of our sin. He may become the payment of our sin. That payment was his shed blood on the cross of Calvary for you and for me, to pay the price of our sin. He did so with so much love in his heart for you and for me. He did so even for those who do not accept him and who reject him, who have sinned. He paid the price, hoping that we would accept his forgiveness, his free gift of salvation. My brothers and sisters, whether you choose to celebrate Christmas or you choose not to, take this day as an opportunity to spread the love of Christ Jesus to those around you. Take a moment when people tell you Happy Holidays or Merry Christmas to tell them Jesus loves you. It doesn't take much. And it doesn't really matter if you celebrate Christmas or not. Let's not allow that to divide us, but let's allow Jesus being born to unite us. Amen. May the Lord receive the honor and the glory.
Jesus is born. There in a manger, he was no stranger, prophesied, now alive, Jesus is born. The bells are ringing, people are singing, angels say with joy, Jesus is born. There in a manger, he was no stranger, prophesied, now alive, Jesus is born. Behold the gift of salvation, a light for all to see, revealing all God's glory, Emmanuel is he.
is the promised one, shining through the darkness. Jesus Christ has come. The bells are ringing, people are singing. Angels say with joy, Jesus is born. There in a manger, he was no stranger. Prophesied, now alive, Jesus is born. The bells are ringing, people are singing. Angels say with joy, Jesus is born. There in a manger, he was no stranger. Prophesied, now alive, Jesus is born. Glory to the King, Lord of everything, Christ is finally come. Glory to the King, let the people sing, hallelujah, hallelujah. The bells are ringing, people are singing, angels say with joy, Jesus is born. Come and receive him, you can believe him, glorified, still alive, Jesus is Lord. The bells are ringing, people are singing, angels say with joy, Jesus is born. Come and receive him, you can believe him, glorified, still alive, Jesus is Lord. Glorified, still alive, Jesus is Lord. Glorified, still alive, Jesus is Lord.
Amen. What a beautiful song by Steve Green titled, Jesus is Born. And now, my brothers and sisters, I invite you to continue listening to our daily Bible reading, which can be found in Revelation chapter 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. So says the Word of God. Revelation chapter 10. I saw still another mighty angel coming down from heaven, clothed with a cloud, and a rainbow was on his head. His face was like the sun, and his feet like pillars of fire. He had a little book open in his hand, and he set his right foot on the sea and his left foot on the land, and cried with a loud voice, as when a lion roars. When he cried out, seven thunders uttered their voices. Now when the seven thunders uttered their voices, I was about to write, but I heard a voice from heaven saying to me, seal up the things which the seven thunders uttered, and do not write them. The angel whom I saw standing on the sea and on the land raised up his hand to heaven and swore by him who lives forever and ever, who created heaven and the things that are in it, the earth and the things that are in it, and the sea and the things that are in it, that there should be delay no longer. But in the days of the sounding of the seventh angel, when he is about to sound, the mystery of God would be finished, as he declared to his servants the prophets. Then the voice which I heard from heaven spoke to me again and said, go, take this little book which is open in the hand of the angel who stands on the sea and on the earth. So I went to the angel and said to him, give me the little book. And he said to me, take and eat it, and I will make your stomach bitter, but it will be as sweet as honey in your mouth. Then I took the little book out of the angel's hand and ate it, and it was sweet as honey in my mouth. But when I had eaten it, my stomach became bitter. And he said to me, you must prophesy again about many peoples, nations, tongues, and kings. Revelations chapter 11. Then I was given a reed like a measuring rod, and the angel stood saying, rise and measure the temple of God, the altar and those who worship there, but leave out the court which is outside the temple and do not measure it, for it has been given to the Gentiles, and they will tread the holy city underfoot for 42 months. And I will give power to my two witnesses, and they will prophesy 1,260 days clothed in sackcloth. These are the two olive trees and the two lampstands standing before God of the earth. And if anyone wants to harm them, fire proceeds from their mouth and devours their enemy. And if anyone wants to harm them, he must be killed in this manner. These have power to shut heaven so that no rain falls in the days of their prophecy, that they have power over waters to turn them to blood and to strike the earth with all plagues as often as they desire. When they finish their testimony, the beast that ascends out of the bottomless pit will make war against them, overcome them, and kill them. And their dead bodies will lie in the streets of the great city, which spiritually is called Sodom and Egypt, where also our Lord was crucified. Then those from the peoples, tribes, and tongues, and nations will see their dead bodies 3.5 days and not allow their dead bodies to be put into graves. And those who dwell on the earth will rejoice over them, make merry, and send gifts to one another, because these two prophets tormented those who dwell on the earth. Now after the 3.5 days, the breath of life from God entered them, and they stood on their feet. The great fear fell on those who saw them, and they heard a loud voice from heaven saying to them, "Come up here." And they ascended to heaven in a cloud, and their enemy saw them. In the same hour, there was a great earthquake, and 1/10 of the city fell. In the earthquake, 7,000 people were killed, and the rest were afraid and gave glory to God of heaven. The second woe is past. Behold, the third woe is coming quickly. Then the seventh angel sounded, and there were loud voices in heaven saying, "The kingdom of this world have become the kingdoms of our Lord and of his Christ, and he shall reign forever and ever." And the 24 elders who sat before God on their thrones fell on their faces and worshiped God, saying, "We give you thanks, O Lord God Almighty, the one who is and who was and who is to come, because you have taken your great power and reigned. The nations were angry, and your wrath has come, and the time of the dead, that they should be judged, and that you should reward your servants, the prophets and the saints, and those who fear your name, small and great, and should destroy those who destroy the earth." Then the temple of God was opened in heaven, and the ark of his covenant was seen in his temple. And there were lightnings, noises, thunderings, an earthquake, and great hail. Revelations chapter 12. Now a great sign appeared in heaven, a woman clothed with the sun, with the moon under her feet, and on her head a garland of 12 stars. Then being with child, she cried out in labor and in pain to give birth. And another sign appeared in heaven. Behold, a great fiery red dragon, having 7 heads and 10 horns and 7 diadems on his head. His tail drew 1/3 of the stars of heaven and threw them to the earth. And the dragon stood before the woman who was ready to give birth, to devour her child as soon as it was born. She bore a male child who was to rule all nations with a rod of iron, and her child was caught up to God and his throne. Then the woman fled into the wilderness, where she has a place prepared by God, that they should feed her there 1,260 days. And war broke out in heaven. Michael and his angels fought with the dragon, and the dragon and his angels fought, but they did not prevail, nor was a place found for them in heaven any longer. So the dragon was cast out, that serpent of old, called the devil and Satan, who deceives the whole world. He was cast to the earth, and his angels were cast out with him. Then I heard a loud voice saying in heaven, "Now salvation and strength and the kingdom of our God and the power of his Christ have come. For the accuser of our brethren, who accused them before our God day and night, has been cast down. And they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony, and they did not love their lives to the death. Therefore rejoice, O heavens, and you who dwell in them. Woe to the inhabitants of the earth and the sea, for the devil has come down to you, having great wrath, because he knows that he has a short time." Now when the dragon saw that he had been cast to the earth, he persecuted the woman who gave birth to the male child. But the woman was given two wings of a great eagle, that she might fly into the wilderness to her place, where she is nourished for a time, and times and half a time, from the presence of the serpent. So the serpent spewed water out of his mouth like a flood after the woman, that he might cause her to be carried away by the flood. But the earth helped the woman, and the earth opened its mouth and swallowed up the flood which the dragon had spewed out of his mouth. And the dragon was enraged with the woman, and he went to make war with the rest of her offspring, who keep the commandments of God and have the testimony of Jesus Christ. Revelation chapter 13. Then I stood on the sand of the sea, and I saw a beast rising up out of the sea, having seven heads and ten horns, and on his horns ten crowns, and on his heads a blasphemous name. Now the beast which I saw was like a leopard. His feet were like the feet of a bear, and his mouth like the mouth of a lion. The dragon gave him his power, his throne, and great authority. And I saw one of his heads as if it had been mortally wounded, and his deadly wound was healed. And all the world marveled and followed the beast. So they worshiped the dragon who gave authority to the beast, and they worshiped the beast, saying, "Who is like the beast? Who is able to make war with him?" And he was given a mouth, speaking great things and blasphemies. And he was given authority to continue for 42 months. Then he opened his mouth in blasphemy against God, to blaspheme his name, his tabernacle, and those who dwell in heaven. It was granted to him to make war with the saints and to overcome them. And authority was given him over every tribe, tongue, and nation. All who dwell on the earth will worship him, whose names have not been written in the book of life of the Lamb, slain from the foundation of the world. If anyone has an ear, let him hear. He who leads into captivity shall go into captivity. He who kills with the sword must be killed with the sword. Here is the patience and the faith of the saints. Then I saw another beast coming up out of the earth, and he had two horns like a lamb and spoke like a dragon. And he exercises all the authority of the first beast in his presence, and causes the earth and those who dwell in it to worship the first beast, whose deadly wound was healed. He performs great signs, so that he even makes fire come down from heaven on the earth in the sight of men. And he deceives those who dwell on the earth by those signs which he was granted to do in the sight of the beast, telling those who dwell on the earth to make an image to the beast who was wounded by the sword and lived. He was granted power to give breath to the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause as many as would not worship the image of the beast to be killed. He causes all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and slave, to receive the mark on their right hand or on their foreheads, and that no one may buy or sell except one who has the mark or the names of the beast or the number of his name. Here is wisdom. Let him who has understanding calculate the number of the beast, for it is the number of a man. His number is 666. Revelations chapter 14. Then I looked, and behold, a Lamb standing on Mount Zion, and with him 144,000, having his Father's name written on their foreheads. And I heard a voice from heaven, like the voice of many waters, and like the voice of loud thunder. And I heard the sound of harpists playing their harps. They sang, as it were, a new song before the throne, before the four living creatures and the elders, and no one could learn that song except the 144,000 who were redeemed from the earth. These are the ones who were not defiled with women, for they are virgins. These are the ones who follow the Lamb wherever he goes. These were redeemed from among men, being first fruits of God and to the Lamb. And in their mouth was found no deceit, for they are without fault before the throne of God. Then I saw another angel flying in the midst of heaven, having the everlasting gospel to preach to those who dwell on the earth, to every nation, tribe, tongue, and people, saying with a loud voice, "Fear God and give glory to him, for the hour of his judgment has come, and worship him who made heaven and earth, the sea, and springs of water." And another angel followed, saying, "Babylon is fallen that great city, because she has made all nations drink of the wine of the wrath of her fornication." Then a third angel followed them, saying with a loud voice, "If anyone worships the beast and his image and receives his mark on his forehead or on his hand, he himself shall also drink of the wine of the wrath of God, which is poured out full strength into the cup of his indignation. He shall be tormented with fire and brimstone in the presence of the holy angels and in the presence of the Lamb. And the smoke of the torment ascends forever and ever, and they have no rest day or night, who worship the beast and his image, and whoever receives the mark of his name. Here is the patience of the saints. Here are those who keep the commandments of God and faith of Jesus." Then I heard a voice from heaven saying to me, "Write, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord from now on." "Yes," says the Spirit, "that they may rest from their labors, and their works follow them." Then I looked, and behold, a white cloud, and on the cloud sat one like the Son of Man, having on his head a golden crown, and in his hand a sharp sickle. And another angel came out of the temple, crying with a loud voice to him who sat on the cloud, "Thrust in your sickle and reap, for the time has come for you to reap, for the harvest of the earth is ripe." So he who sat on the cloud thrust in his sickle on the earth, and the earth was reaped. Then another angel came out of the temple which is in heaven, he also having a sharp sickle. And another angel came out from the altar, who had power over fire, and he cried with a loud cry to him who had the sharp sickle, saying, "Thrust in your sharp sickle and gather the clusters of the vine of the earth, for her grapes are fully ripe." So the angel thrust his sickle into the earth and gathered the vine of the earth and threw it into the grape winepress of the wrath of God. and the winepress was trampled outside the city, and blood came out of the winepress up on the horses' bridles for 1,600 furlongs. Amen. May we be blessed by the reading of the scriptures. My brothers and sisters, no matter if you celebrate Christmas or not, no matter if you decorate with tree and lights and ornaments or you don't, let us give the message to those around us, the good news, the gospel of Jesus, that he was born. Let that fact that Jesus was born unite us and guide us. And now we ask that the blessed love of God, the grace and peace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the companion and communion of the Holy Spirit, our great counselor, be with all of his children, now and forever. Amen. Blessings to you, my brothers and sisters. Thank you for tuning in to our daily devotional, whether you tuned in on SCC English Ministry YouTube channel or you tuned in on SCC Radio. Thank you so much for your support, and may God bless you.